Hey folks, this is Jeff Posnick from the YouTube Developer Relations team, and I'm coming at you with another episode of YouTube Developers Live. We're going to continue our series of shows focusing on the ways developers can move from version 2 of our data API to the newer version 3. And today's topic covers something that's a little less technical, but certainly important for developers to understand, and that's how Quota works in version 3 of the data API. So anybody who's had a history using the YouTube APIs knows that understanding how Quota works is quite important. It is possible to run into Quota issues if you're too aggressive with the types of API calls that you're making. And there are some changes in how Quota is handled in version 3 that we're going to cover shortly. So kind of the best overview of what's new with Quota in version 3 is that there's a lot more visibility as to what's actually going on. Quota in version 2 of the API was a little bit more opaque. We didn't have any exact numbers attached to operations. We didn't tell you, you've reached 50% of your quota usage on this given day. You kind of just kept making calls until they stopped working and you got a quota error. And, the best practice at that point was to pause a little bit and then try to make calls again. But in version 3, we have a lot more information that we're sharing with developers, and hopefully that could help you plan ahead and make sure that you're making intelligent choices about how you're using the quota that you do have. So the first thing to keep in mind is that there is a global bucket of quota that gets assigned to each developer registration in the API console. Everybody needs to register before they could use version 3 of the API. And everybody gets 50 million quota units. If you played around with the data API back when it first launched, you might have seen a lower limit of 5 million quota units. We bumped that up to 50 million quota units a little while ago. And that is something we definitely anticipate should be enough quota for the vast majority of uses out there. So the way those quota units work is that there's really a global pool. And every time your application makes an API call, some quota gets deducted from that pool. If you get down to zero, then you've run out of quota for the day. There is also some shorter term quota limits that are in place to protect, a rogue instance of your application from going completely out of control and draining all your quota. And that's actually something that you have a little bit more control of, setting what you want those per IP or per user limits to be. So let's take a kind of deep dive into the tools that we have for understanding the quota usage and managing those quotas and per IP limits. And I'm going to pull up a screen share right now. And you can see what I have open here is this page that we have linked to from our documentation from developers.google.com/YouTube. You'll find it in left-hand nav over here under Data API version 3 tools and Quota Explorer. And this gives you insight as to how many quota units each of the different version 3 operations consume. And just basic rule of thumb, operations that are read-only and especially searches tend to take very few quota units, and operations that involve some sort of writing or uploading or deleting things tend to take more quota units. So if I go over here and say I'd like to do a search, and the only thing that you could do with the search is a list, and you're saying you want to get the snippet back, that's going to end up costing you 2 quota units. So you could do 25 million of those a day, basically. The reason that there is this column over here for parts is that we do charge a little bit more for additional parts that you request. This comes not so much for searches, but like if you're doing a videos list, for instance, and you say that you want to get back both the snippet and the content details, that bumps it up from 3 quota units to 5 quota units. And the idea being, we have to retrieve a little bit more information on the back end, so it's going to cost a little bit more for you to make that call. Still though, that particular operation costs 5 quota units. You can make 10 million of those per day from your application, basically. Let's try a couple of other things like write operations. If we were going to go over here and say we don't want to do a playlists insert and specify this, you'll see that this is 53 quota units. For doing a playlist insert. So a little bit of a higher cost because this is a write operation. Your application can't do quite as many of them. And, again, still we think the quota that we give people by default is quite generous. And finally, the operation that ends up taking the most quota currently in the API is a video upload. And, you know, again, you can specify this part over here, but maybe I'll put in like, you know, status or something too. That bumps it up to 1600 quota that takes. So that still lets you do quite a few uploads from your application per day. I think it's something around 30,000. So that's not a small amount by any means. You know, even though that this operation does cost more from a raw quota cost perspective, we still think it should be enough to get you going for most of your usage. And I want to jump now to some tools that you could use to actually see how much quota your application that maybe is already live out there is consuming, and kind of just help you intelligently plan for what's going on. And this is done via the Google Developers Console. So I'm over here, and it's the sample application that I have, accessed via cloud.google.com/console. And I've gone over here to the APIs section under APIs and Auth, and I've chosen the Data API v3. And you'll see here, this actually gives you quick access to the API Explorer that we've talked about before. But what I want to do from over here is click on the Reports button. And this is going to take me actually to a different page, which is a little bit more of our older interface for interacting with the APIs console. But this is the interface that shows you how much quota your application is actually consumed on a historical basis. And this actually, let me rephrase that, it shows you how many operations your application made. So this is a raw number of API calls. And probably it's a little small on the screen right here, but you can see a nice little chart for Data API v3 usage. So this doesn't directly map in this chart to the actual quota consumed. In order to do that, you kind of have to dig down a little bit and take a look at the methods that your application has been calling. And you know, see over here that there's been 2.3 million search list operations, some playlist items list operations, and so on and so forth. And it gives you a good idea as to you know, what you're actually doing from your application. You know, if you have just written some simple script and you've deployed it to your server and you're the only one running it, this probably isn't as interesting as if like you've written an application, you've released it in some app store, and you really are interested in seeing, you know, how much usage it's getting for all the different API methods from all the users out there. So hopefully that's useful information for folks. There's also just one extra tool that I'm not going to go into too much detail about, but it could be useful. This is Quotas from that same tab over here. And if you go to the set per user limits, you will see you'll have a chance to change the quota that each individual user of your application is granted. And you'll see over here for Data API v3, for instance, the default is 2 units per second per user. So if you do have an application that's deployed widely and you know you are concerned that the default limit is not large enough, or you want to tighten the default limit a bit, you have the ability to adjust it over here and make sure that you know no single user of your application can really deplete that global quota pool all the way down to zero. So hopefully this information was useful for folks out there getting started with the V3 API, or whether you've already been using it for a while and just didn't know that you could check in on the quota. And stay tuned for more videos in the series, and we hope it's helping folks make the move from V2 to V3. This is Jeff Posnick from the Developer Relations team, and have a great day, everybody.